above all others.
Above all others,
we lay our crosses.
We lay our crosses
and worship.
And worship.
Oh, be lifted.
Oh, be lifted.
Above all others.
Above all others.
Time, I just want you to lift up your voice wherever you are and give him all the glory. He is worthy. I want you to lift up your voice. Sometimes we just hide behind the songs that the singers are singing, and we think that we are giving worship to the Most High God, but I want it to come from within your heart. Let it rise, let it rise, let it rise. Tell him how you love him. Tell him how he's been good to you. Tell him, let him hear it this morning. The Lamb of God, he is worthy of praise. You can lift up your hands. You can lift up your voice. Go on your knees. Give him all the glory. He is worthy. Masha da 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 da. Is there any God like this God? He is the greatest of all. Masha da 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 da. Iraka da 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 mama Masha da da da. Jesus, you are a hiding place, our rock of ages. We hide in you, and we are safe. We give you all the glory. glory. Mata la 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 ya bo shada. Ira pada bada gade ya mo sada la la baba. Lamb of God, you are worthy. Lamb of God, Ancient of Days, we bow before your holy name. We bow before your throne, giving you the glory, giving you the praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Mata la 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 ya bo shada. Oh, mata la 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 ya bo shada. Most High God, to the Lamb of God, He is worthy, He is worthy, He is worthy, yeah, yeah. Oh, I hear you so. Oh, Grandma, oh, Grandma, yeah. Oh, Grandma, yeah. Oh, Grandma, oh, Grandma, I hear you. Oh, Grandma. God, you want to put him at the right place, Jesus. High above, high above, high above, high above, yeah, yeah. He is the Most High God, oh Jehovah, oh Jehovah. Lift your hands, join me, say Jehovah to the Most High God. Hallelujah. Glory, Jesus, we give you all the praise. We crown you as Lord of all. We crown you as the King of Kings. There is none like you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, you are King and Lord of Lords. Let me hear you say,
we give you glory
and the honor.
And
oh, Jesus, worthy.
You are the Lord.
Let your name be glorified.
Oh,
you are the Lord.
You are the Lord. Let your name be glorified.
Yeah, you are the Lord.
You are the Lord.
Let your name. We give you all the glory.
We give you glory.
And the honor.
You are the Lord. Let your name be glorified.
Omega, you are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega. Let me hear you say,
you are Yahweh, Alpha.
Tell him,
and Omega.
Tell him, yeah.
Time
you are. yes you are, yes you are, yes you are, yes you are, yes you are. You are Yahweh, you are Yahweh. Jesus, Jesus, we crown you, Lord.
You are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega.
Father, we give you praise and we give you worship. We give you all the adoration and we say you are God and you are God alone. Creator of the lands and of the coast, fainted not, neither is weary. There is no searching of your understanding. You give power unto the weak and increase might to them that have no strength. Even the youth faint and the young men utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord, they renew their strength. And by your grace, they mount up with wings as eagles. They run and they are not weary. They walk and they faint not. This morning we extol your holy name. Thou which is and which was and which is to come, the Almighty. Your name alone be glorified. As the Ancient of Days, the El Olam, who art God from beginning to ending and from everlasting to everlasting. Father, we say this morning, let the atmosphere be seized for a divine encounter. Encounter with that which comes from above. Let there be birthings of the order of salvation. Grant that by the workings of the Holy Ghost, sinners will be transformed into saints. And by the end of this encounter, Lord, your entrance by light will give understanding even to the simple. We plead the blood against any voice of accusation, and we declare the dynamics upon Mount Zion activated for our service. We speak the presence of innumerable company of angels, and we speak the sprinkling of blood that speaketh better things than that of Abel. We are marked so that every calamity passes over, and by the outstretched arm that is able to do exceedingly above everything we can think or ask. Father, let it be that peace that surpasses all understanding will be the portion of your children. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen.
God bless you, children of the Lord. This is a good place to put your hands together and celebrate God's goodness. It's a wonderful Sunday morning, and as God will have it, we are in his presence. I always like to remind you that church is not in a place, church is in a presence. In the account of Acts, when the Holy Spirit came, the Bible says in Acts chapter 2, and it came to pass on the day of Pentecost that they were all together with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the place. And then there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon them. And by that, everyone began to speak in a new tongue as the Holy Ghost gave them utterance. So you realize that the presence is what made the difference in the place. Church does not happen in a place. Church happens in a presence. When the presence fills the place, then the precedence for divine intercourse has begun. And so wherever you are, understand that by the invocation of the presence of I Am, the place moves from a normal habitation to a sanctuary where divine ordinances and services can be performed. The grace of the Lord is with us without measure by an immutable promise. Jesus said, I will be with you to the end of the age. He said emphatically, I will never leave you comfortless, and I will never leave you without a divine company. And so we have, by the immutability of the counsel of the divine, the words of the Lord that do not fail. We have, as by that order, the promise of divine companionship. So when we invoke the presence by worship, by faith, by the plea for God to be present in our midst, every place where we are is filled. The Holy Ghost filled the place in Acts before he filled the people who were in the place. Church is not in a place. Church is in a presence. So wherever you are, even if you are alone, that place becomes a divine sanctuary unto the glory of the Lord. Amen. This morning, before we go ahead to hear the word of the Lord, I want us to pray. You know, when we meet in the arena of grace, one of the things that have been prescribed is that we pray. 1 Thessalonians 5:17 says, pray without ceasing. It is the duty of men to pray. The scripture says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and turn from their foolish ways, then I will hear and I will heal their land. We are in turbulent times, and even if personally you have not been affected with this pandemic, it behooves us as children of the Lord and ambassadors of the kingdom of the divine to lift up intercession for people and areas that are being plagued. And so we will pray. We are not in fear, and so we're not going to lock down everything we are talking about to COVID-19. You see, faith is not the frantic expressions of positivity. Faith is staying power by the authority of a decision made by grace that God is our refuge. And so we do not have to frantically express certain positivity in the guise of having faith. No, we are at rest. We are calm. Remember, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. A sound mind makes you have a better understanding of love. And then a good understanding of love is what provokes the power of love to perform what love has promised. So if we do not have a sound mind, we cannot claim to be having faith. If we are anxious and double-minded and we are troubled on every side in our imagination, we cannot profess to have faith in the power of God to save. So a sound mind, then a sound apprehension of love, and then the benefit of the power of love moving to perform what love has promised. So we're going to pray. God gave me something when I was praying about the COVID-19, the pandemic, and I was asking God, what is it that we have to do? And God says, whatever has to be done, he has done already. We have to just appropriate by having faith in him. And he gave me something in Deuteronomy chapter 33, and I'm reading from 24 to 27. This is when Moses was pronouncing blessings on the tribes of Israel, and he got to the blessing of Asher. And so Deuteronomy 33 from verse 24 saying, and of Asher he said, let Asher be blessed with children. Let him be acceptable to his brethren, and let him dip his foot in oil. Then it goes on to say, thy shoes shall be iron and brass, and as thy days, so shall thy strength be. There is none like unto the God of Yeshurun, who rideth upon the heaven in thy help and in his excellency on the sky. The eternal God is thy refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. So we are looking at the attributes of God in Deuteronomy 33:27, and it is the attribute of being eternal. The eternal God is thy refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Now, the reason why God inspired that we pray this prayer is that, you know, this pandemic seizes you and it cuts short the number of your days. This is a threat on life. It comes as a plague to destroy and ultimately to take lives. So there is a pandemic that is released from the pit of hell by the craftiness of the dark domain to cut short the lives of people. But you see, in the account of scripture, anything that threatens your number of days, the antidote of it is God's eternal nature. It is eternity that rises up as an antidote to anything that wants to shorten the number of your days. You see, it is the Ancient of Days who will help you fulfill the number of your days. The Bible says in Deuteronomy that ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and water. And he says, I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. There shall none cast their young, nor be barren in thy land. The number of thy days I will fulfill. Deuteronomy 23, 25, and 26. God says, the number of your days I will fulfill. It is the Ancient of Days who sustains the number of days of a person. So anytime there is a disease, there is an attack, there's an onslaught from hell attacking or threatening the number of our days, we have to invoke God's eternal nature, the El Olam effect, from everlasting to everlasting. So it's the Bible says in Deuteronomy 24:33-27, it says, the eternal God is thy refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Spiritually, the coronavirus is using the roots from the sea and the power of the air. And God says, the eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. You see, it has its sources from marine power. And what deals with marine power is the everlasting arms underneath the saints of the Lord. So we are going to lift up our voices in prayer. He says, let Asher dip his foot in oil. When he dips his foot in oil, his shoes shall be iron and brass, and as his days, so shall his strength be. That means the number of his days will be commensurate to his strength. He will grow younger and stronger when his feet is in oil. So we are lifting up a prayer, and you're saying, number one, God, we dip our foot in the oil of divine healing, and by that process, our days shall be equal to the number, our days shall be equal to our strength. As we grow older, we will grow stronger in the name of the Lord Jesus. Lift up your voice and say this after me. Say, in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
I invoke
the attribute
of the Lord
as eternal.
Say, I invoke the divine attribute
of being everlasting.
I invoke
the El Olam dimension
of the living God.
The
Ancient of Days,
sustain the number
of my days. Say it aloud. Say, the Ancient of Days,
sustain the number
of my days. Say, thou living God,
thou eternal
God,
the God
of love,
from everlasting
to everlasting,
the changeless God,
thou ageless God,
arise
with healing
in your wings,
and sustain
the number
of my days.
Say, eternal God,
everlasting Father,
be thou
my refuge.
Eternal God,
let your arms,
the everlasting arms,
be my support,
be my immunity
from beneath.
From this hour,
I prophesy
immunity
to coronavirus.
I prophesy immunity
to every disease.
I prophesy
immunity
to infirmity.
From this hour,
as my days,
so shall my strength be.
I come against
the onslaught
from the dark domain.
I come against
the onslaught
from the hordes of hell.
Say, I come against
the plans
of the enemy
by the power
of grace
that comes
from above,
by the power
of eternal
disposition
from above.
I declare
the devices
of the wicked
nullified,
the mechanics
of darkness
frustrated,
the traps
of the enemy
disappointed.
Every disease
by the protocol
of the Passover,
we declare
access denied
in my habitation,
access denied
in my locality,
access denied
in my city,
access denied
in my workplace,
access denied
in my dwelling places.
From this hour,
we command
evil winds,
Passover,
angels of death,
Passover,
arrows of hell,
Passover,
mechanics of infirmity,
Passover,
spells,
divinations,
enchantments,
none of you
will survive.
None of you
will perform
the intention
of hell
against my life.
By the blood,
immunity is permanent.
Now lift up your voice and begin to pray. If you can speak in tongues, speak in tongues. The Ancient of Days is the one that will fulfill the number of your days. Nothing shall by any means threaten your existence.
not a disease, not a pandemic, not an epidemic, not any plant from the dark domain. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Lift up your voice and pray like a child of God. The plans of the wicked, my God, reveal and reveal. In the name of the Lord Jesus,
amen.
Spirit of the living God, we thank you.
Amen.
And we bless your holy name for the stirrings of understanding that enables us to have faith and to fight the battles that you have ordained for us to have mastery in. We are praying in the name of the Lord Jesus that, O God, thou that hearest prayer, thou that art the consolation of all flesh, we come unto you and we appeal to the infallible blood that speaks exoneration, that speaks exception, that speaks exclusion for us in the time of any mishap. From this hour, no devil happenstance will have us as a victim. It is ordained and it is settled by grace. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Wow, put your hands together. We have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows are rolling. And we are fasting to the rock which cannot be moved, grounded firm and deep. And it is in the Savior's love. The blood makes us victors and never victims. And so we are not living in fear. And we will go on celebrating the goodness of the Lord. Because once our feet have been dipped in oil, as our days, so shall our strength be. We grow older and yet we grow stronger in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. We're talking about the laws of a divine exodus, the protocol of the divine exodus. You see, in the account of Hebrews chapter 6, the Bible makes us understand that when God made a promise to Abraham, I think it's from verse 13, Hebrews chapter 6, either 13 or 14, said, for when God made promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swear by himself, saying, blessing I will bless thee, and multiplying I will multiply thee. And so when he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. For men verily swear by the greater, and an oath for confirmation is to them an end of all strife, wherein God willing more abundantly to show unto the heirs of promise the immutability of his counsel, confirmed it by an oath, that by two immutable things in which it was impossible for God to lie, we might have a strong consolation, who have fled for refuge and have taken hold of the hope that is set before us. And the scripture says, which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, both sure and steadfast, and which entereth into that within the veil, whither the forerunner is for us entered, even Jesus, made an high priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. The Bible makes us understand that when God spoke to Abraham, he gave him a promise, and he gave him a promise under oath. And under oath means without fail. You see, normally, a God that cannot lie does not need to swear. It is men who lie, who are subject to change, who have shadows of turning in us and in our doings. We need to swear. But a God that does not lie And a God that cannot lie in the right context of scriptural vocabulary, a God that cannot lie, does not need to say, I swear. He doesn't need to take an oath. His counsel and his words are yea and amen. Remember, Jesus says, let your yea be yea and your nay be nay. Because whatsoever becometh more than these is of evil. If your words are not yes meaning yes and no meaning no, Jesus says you are already prone to evil. So the words of the Lord, if he opens up his mouth and utters something, it is settled forever. But then the Bible says he was more willing abundantly to show unto the people who he was speaking to that he has an ordained earnestness in his sovereign being to perform what he has spoken. He added an oath. So now the promise given to the children of the Lord was by a sure word and an oath. Two immutable things in which it makes it impossible for God to lie. God cannot lie. So now we are looking at something that God told Abraham and told him under oath that they are going into a promised land. So you realize that for us believers, the entry into the promised land is not as a result of motivational sensationalism. No, we are not going to a good place because we feel a motivational need to. We are going to a good place because it is the provision God has made for us under oath.